So good morning. Today we have stiffness method, second part we can say, that is application of this method to frames. We are going to analyze four problems over here. So first problem, we have analyzed the frame ABCD as shown in figure by stiffness method. So this problem we have already solved by using slope deflection method. So steps, if you will see, we have same as beams. So first we have to go for kinematic indeterminacy. We have only one, which is theta b. Non-sway frame, so we do not have delta over there. Then determine fixed end moments. So for UDL, we have minus WL square by 12 and plus WL square by 12. So minus 37.5 kilonewton meter, 37.5 kilonewton meter. Go to member BC, which will be minus WL by 8 and plus WL by 8. So minus 50 plus 50 kilonewton meter. And member BD, we have minus P into L, which is anti-clockwise. So fixed end moment, we have anti-clockwise. So minus P into L, which will be minus 210 kilonewton meter. Now we have FBD in this way. Then we have restraint structure. So restraint structure means we have to make all supports, all rigid joint and supports as fixed supports. BD as overhang, so we need not require to make it as fixed at D. Now, then by this restraint, we are going to find out FDL value, that is force at non-zero displacement due to external loads. Now we are going to apply here theta b equal to 1, and that is 4EI by L. So 4EI by 3, we have to apply for BA also and for BC also. For BA, we have 4EI by 3, and for BC, we have 4EI by 4. So total S value, we have addition of these two. So knowing values, all these values, we are in position to find non-zero displacement. So we can see first we have, that is force analysis of restraint structure. And we have FDL, and FDL we will get MFBA plus MFBC plus MFBD. So we are at B, so we have to consider all fixed end moment at B, and we have three fixed end moment at B, so we are going to get this value of FDL, that is MFBA 37.5, BC minus 50, and BD minus 210, and that will give us minus 222.5 kilonewton meter. Now go to next step, which will be your stiffness formulation, and we have only one unknown, so S will be 1. So whatever your non-zero displacement, that will be size your stiffness. So if 1, then we have 1 only. If we have 2 non-zero displacements, then we have 2 by 2. And if we have 3, then we have 3 by 3. So S equal to 4EI by L BA plus 4EI by L BC, and that will give me 4EI by 3 plus 4EI by 4, that will be 2.33EI. So we have formulation of equation, FD equal to, we have FDL plus S into theta B. And from this we will get value of theta B, and that is equal to 95.49 upon EI. So knowing value of theta B, we can use slope deflection method, and by that slope deflection method, we are in position to find the final moments. So we are with a member moments, MAB we have first, so MFAB plus 4EI by L theta A plus 2EI by L theta B. Now in this, if we will see, then in this we have theta A, that is equal to 0, so my second term becomes 0, and therefore we have only first and third term. So this term we have 0. So moment is 26.16 kilonewton meter positive. If you see slope deflection, actually that there we have written it as minus 26.16 kilonewton meter. That is correction is there, and actual value we have plus. Now go to MBA. Here also my value of theta A, that is going to be equal to 0. So this value is 0. And then we will get this value of MBA, which will be 164.82 kilonewton meter. Then go MBC. For MBC, we have this value as minus 50 plus 95.49, and that gives me 45.49 kilonewton meter. Go to MCB. and we will get this value by substituting theta b, because again we have theta c that is equal to 0, so we have only two terms over there. So 2EI by L theta c, this will become 0, so this value we have 0. So we have this value also 0, and from this we are going to get this value of MCB, which will be 97.75 kilonewton meter. And now MBD, so we have minus 210 kilonewton meter, we will get value of BD. So in this way we have these values, the values of final moments, and from this we are in position to draw bending moment diagram. Now I have plotted for this only, because we have correction this, we have here clockwise plus value, and therefore whatever correction we have in slow deflection that we have made over here, so we have this will be 26.16 clockwise, so goes down, and then we have other as it is. So this will be BMD due to final moments, and then we have this will be BMD due to simple support. So this is BMD by superposition. Now go to second, in which we have kinematic indeterminacy 3. Here you can see we have theta b, then we have theta c, non-sway frame, so no delta. So we have dk2. Now go for FBD. So you can see we have this as FBD. So here actually, if we will say FBD, then we have to show reaction over there. So I have reaction RC over here, then I have reaction HC over here. So we have this is FBD diagram. Then you can go to restraint structure. So for restraint structure, we have to make this rigid joint, which is at B, that is also fixed. So restraint structure means we have to make all rigid joint and all support as fixed. And from this, we are going to find FDL. Now F, we will have the unknown 2. So we have FDL values 2, FDL 1. Now you can see we will have MFBA plus MFBC. That will be FDL 1. And FDL 2, we have MFCB. So that we will see in next slide. Then we have theta B equal to 1. So we have to go for BA also, theta B equal to 1, for BC also. Now for BC, we have I equal to 2I. So we have this will be clockwise, theta should be clockwise, that is non-zero displacement, we have to apply clockwise. And then we have 4EI by 6, this is also 4EI by 6. And then we have this will be 2EI by 4. Now you can see how we will go for the stiffness matrix element. So we can have this theta b, this we will give as number 1, and theta c we can have number 2. So now we have this will be at 1, so I will mention it as 1, and this is at 2, so I will mention it as 2. Now where we have applied unit displacement, theta b equal to 1, which is my number 1, and therefore I will go here as 1. Here we have again applied at 1. So this shows force that is at non-zero displacement 1, that is at B, due to unit displacement applied at B. In the same way, force at second non-zero displacement, that is C, due to unit displacement applied at 1. So we have this as 1, 1, as 2. Now go to theta C equal to 1. So here I have, when I will say theta equal to 1, so I have to make this support as a simple support, and my this support becomes fixed support. And then we have to apply theta C equal to 1. So by applying theta C equal to 1, we have to go for moment, and then we will get moment in this fashion. Now we have to give stiffness element number. So we have S at 1, we have this as S at 2. Where we have applied unit displacement, we have applied at 2. So I will give number 2 as 1, 2, and then we have this will be S 2, 2. Likewise, we will get this stiffness matrix, and then we can have formulation of equations. So S 2, 1, S 2, 2, and then we have, so this will be straight to fixed end moment, which will be minus 30 plus 30. Remember, BC, we have minus 80, we have 80 kilonewton meter. Now, step 3, we have restraint structure force analysis. FDL1, I will get MFBA plus MFBC, I already mentioned over there. So minus 50 kilonewton meter FD L2, we will get it as 80 kilonewton meter. Now go to step 4, which is stiffness formulation. So we have S11, we have calculated, which we will have 4 EI by L for BA plus 4 EI by L BC. And that will give me value as 2.67 EI. Now go to S21, which will be 2 into 2 EI upon 4, which will be EI value. Now S21, you can go, that is 2 EI. So here actually this will be S11, then we have this will be S12. So this is 12. And then we have EI, then we have S21, again same. So that is EI, and S22, we will get it as 2 EI. So next we have formulation of equations, and then in this we have FD1 is equal to FDL1 plus S11 theta B plus S12 theta C. Generally, in most of the cases, we have value 0. So if we have moment over there, that is external couple is acting, then we have this value. Otherwise, we have value in most of the cases at 0. And then we will substitute all these values. And that will give me first equation, 2.667 EI theta B plus EI theta C equal to 50. Similarly, I can go for formulation of second equation by substituting values of S21 and S22. And that will give me second equation, which is EI theta B plus 2 EI theta C equal to minus 80. So knowing these two equations, we can solve this for unknown displacement, and we will get these values, theta B 41.53 upon EI and theta C 60.77 upon EI. So likewise, we are going to get these values of non-zero displacement or unknown displacement. And knowing these values, we are in position to determine the final moments by using slope deflection method. Now, as we have seen, here my value of theta A, that is going to be zero as fixed end, so it is not involved in the next part. Similarly, in FBA also, so we have theta A zero, and likewise, I will get MAB minus 16.616, MBA 57.69, MBC, we will get it as minus 57.71 kilonewton, and as C, we have rollers, simple support, so my final moment should be zero over there, and you can see you will get this final moment as zero. So that means end supports, whenever we have simple or roller, that value or final, so no final moment at this, we should have zero. So we have, this will be problem number two. I have not plotted BMD. Now we will go to problem number three, where we have this one. Now you can see this diagram. In this diagram, actually, we have now three unknown displacements. So we have theta A, we have theta B, and then we have delta. So now we have to first go to DK. We have three, that is theta A, theta B, and delta. Delta we have due to say because support A is roller support, and your beam can move, and as beam can move, so that automatically my column can sway. So due to sway, beam will not affect. We will, as we are neglecting axial deformation, so we have effect on column only. So now we have fixed end moment, your restraint structure. So we have this structure A, we will have fixed support, B, we will have fixed support, and then we have FDL. If we will one say, then we have FDL. One is MFAB. FDL2, we have MFBA plus MFBC, and FDL3, so that will be reaction at B. Because sway we have at B, and therefore we are going to say that is reaction at B, because linear displacement related with reaction or forces, and angular displacements are related with moments. So now here we will go theta A equal to 1. So we are going to apply 4 EI by L. So now in this, we are this value as 2 EI by L. And now if we will go to reaction, as our moment is to the beam, and as moment is to the beam, so my value of this reaction, this value is going to be zero over here, because no reaction will be developed in horizontal direction, because that is your axial force for AB. Now we have to write down this, so I will mention it as S1, then I will mention it as S2, and then I will mention it as S3, because now my delta is 3. So if we will name over there, then I can say theta A, we have number 1, then we can have B, then I can mention it as 2, and then we can have delta displacement, which will have number 3. So for 1, we have moment, for 2, we have moment, for 3, we have reaction. And then we have now applied theta A1, so that means that is at 1, so my this value becomes as 1, 1, then my this value becomes as 2, 1, and my this value becomes as 3, 1. Means these stiffness values we got due to unit displacement at 1. Similarly, we can go, so you can see as 1, 1, we have as 2, 1, and then we have as 3, 1. And then in the same way, we can go theta B equal to 1. Now we have to apply for BA also, and we have to apply for BC also. So now we have this value for AB, then we have this value for BA, and now we have to go for reaction. So now you can see reaction will be due to BC only, and your moments are clockwise. So my reaction should be in such a way that it should develop anti-clockwise moment. So now in this way, we have to find it. So we will get this 6 EI upon 4 square. That I will explain in next slide. Now we have this actually, if we will again go for this, I will explain. So that will not be explained again in next problem. So I will mention it as S at 1. So we have this will be S at 2. S at 2 we have to add, that is of BA and BC. And then we have this will be S at 3. And we have applied unit displacement at 2, so I have this will be as 3, 2, then I have this will be as 2, 2, and then I have this will be at as 1, 2. So likewise, we will get these values for stiffnesses due to unit displacement at B. Now I will switch over to the last, which is delta equal to 1. So we have applied unit displacement. And for unit displacement, moment required is 6 EI delta upon L square. Delta is 1, so it comes 6 EI upon 4 square. Now you can see over here, now as my moments are anti-clockwise, so moment developed due to reaction at C should be clockwise, then only it will balance it. And then if you will go to the reaction that will be seen in next, so we will get it as moment. You can take moment about C equal to 0, and you will get it as 6 EI minus 6 EI upon 4 square minus 6 EI upon 4 square plus RB into 4. And that will give me RB is equal to 12 EI upon 4 cube. And then we have to go for this. So this is my S1. Sorry, this is my S2 because this is at B. So if I will go to A, then I have this will be S1. And then I can go to delta value, then I have this will be S3. So where we will have applied unit displacement, so we have applied unit displacement at 3. So we have this will be S3, 3. Then we have this will be S1, 3. And then we have this will be S2, 3. So we have likewise these stiffness values. And then we can have calculation of this. So we have now first fixed end moments. So we will get fixed end moments over there. So minus 45 plus 45, then we have MFBC. We have to apply this formula, that is partial UDL, and we will get these values as minus 14.0623.44. Now you can see this. So here we are going to be force analysis of restraint structure. FDL1, we will get minus 45 kilonewton meter. That is directly MFAB. FDL2, we have MFBA plus MFBC comes 30.94 kilonewton meter, and then FDL3, that will be reaction at B. So we have to take moment about C0. Now I am showing these moments. We have minus 14.06, 23.44. Reaction will be in rightward because we are going to get moment due to this, or we have considered reaction load towards left. So automatically reaction will go towards right. And then we have H. So this will be HB into 4 clockwise minus 75 into 1 into 3.5. So we are taking moment about C minus 14.06 plus 23.44. And we will have this value 63.28 kilonewton. So my FDL3, that is HB, which will be 63.28 kilonewton. So knowing this value of HB, I can go with force analysis for unit displacement, that is stiffness matrix, and that already we have calculated. So we have this 2.67 EI, then we have S21, we have 1.33 EI, S31, then we have S12, then we have S22, then we have S23, and then we have S32, and then we have S13, 23, and 33. These values we are going to write down. So you can see first values we have S11, so S21, S31. These are due to unit displacement at 1, S12, 22, 32 due to unit displacement at 2, and 33, 13, 23, and 33 due to unit displacement at 3. So knowing these values, we can formulate the equation. So we have FD1 equal to FDL1 plus S11 theta A plus 12 theta B. Likewise, we will get first equation by substituting the respective values, and we got this as first equation. Similarly, we can have FD2, FDL2, and similarly substituting values, we are going to get second equation that will be 1.33 EI theta, 3.67 EI theta B, minus 0.375 EI delta, minus 30.94. Now, in this FD1 and FD2 0, because we do not have any couple acting at theta A and theta B. Now, FD3 will be 0 if we do not have any horizontal reaction, horizontal force at B. And we do not have force at B. If some force is acting at B, then we have to consider it as FD3. And then we have this value, and then if you substitute this, then you are going to get third equation, and that we will get in this fashion. Knowing these three equations, we can find now non-zero displacement or unknown displacement, and that will give us theta A 56.85 upon EI, theta B minus 79.98 upon EI, and delta minus 497 upon 46 upon EI. And then we can have final moments. So we have these final moments. Now in AB, we do not have sway. Sway is related with column, not beam. And therefore, we have MAB value. So that value comes 0 because we have A as roller support. Then we can go MBA. So we can have MBA. So substitute value of theta is substitute value of theta B. And by substituting, we will get it as minus 92.48 kilonewton meter. So this should be kilonewton meter, not newton meter. So we have this as kilonewton meter. Now go to MBC, and then MBC, you substitute the respective values. So now in this, we have theta C zero. So we cannot, we do not have second term, and then substitute this value. And we will get it as minus 92.05 kilonewton. Sorry, this I will get it as plus 92.05 kilonewton meter. So this will be plus, and if you will see, we have MBA value. That MBA value we got as minus 92.48. So this comes plus because we have this third term in this one. So this third term we have minus minus plus, and this value you will get as plus 92.50 kilonewton meter. MCB you can calculate by substituting respective value. Again, theta C zero, so we have two terms only. And if you calculate this value, then you will get it as 170 kilonewton meter. So knowing all these values, we can plot bending moment diagram, so that also not plotted over here. And then we have last, that is analyze the frame ABCD as shown in figure by stiffness method. Now we will have this kinematic indeterminacy 3. So generally problems we do not have above 3, because if you have matrix or if you have simultaneous equation, then also it is difficult to solve this. And then again to go for slope deflection equation, then your calculations are going to be increased. Then we have first fixed end moment. So MF AB, we have minus 1.125 MF BA, 0.375 kilonewton meter. Similarly, we can go for MF BC, MF CB. Then we can have for a member CD, then MF CD, we have minus 3.33 MF BC. Then we have 3.33 kilonewton meter. So we have, these are the final fixed end moments for your three members. Now go to restraint structures. So we have restraint at B, we have restraint at C. So if I will say unknowns, we have first unknown, we have theta B, then second unknown, we have theta C. So I can say this will be number one, which will be theta B. So FDL1, if I will talk, then I have FBA plus is BC. Then second I have that is theta C. Then I can have this MF CB plus MF CD. And third we are going to be delta. And then in that case, delta, I have to find reaction at C. So we have, these will be FDL3. So as last time we have calculated reaction in the stiffness matrix. So for that one, I have to apply theta B1 will be for BA also, which will be for BC also. And then we have these values. Now I will not again explain in detail this. Already we have covered this in last example. So give numbers to this reaction we have to find over here. So this also we have calculated over there. So we have now values here we do not have. So we have slope for AB only, and therefore reaction will be at B, not at C. Now we have to add RB plus RC. In last, we are only at B reaction. Here we have at B also and at C. And my both columns are going to be sway at B and C respectively. Therefore, we have to add the values. Then we can have value S11. We can have addition of the two. S21, we have this value. Now S31, we are going to get reaction at B, which will be again anticlockwise, so minus. Now you can go to theta C equal to 1, and in this we are going to get again 4EI by L for theta BC also and for CB also, CD also. And then you are going to add this, then you have to find reaction. Now reaction here at B is 0, but we are going to get reaction at C. So we have RB plus RC, so we are only at C only. And then again you can give due to 2, so second number you are going to get as 2. And 1, 2, 3, these are your number given to the displacement. And then we have last, that is delta, we have to now apply at both, at B also, and we have to apply this at C also. So you can see we have applied at both. Now here you can see we have value 12 EI upon 4 cube, and here we have 6 EI, sorry, 12 EI upon 2 cube. So we have 2 meter for CD and 4 meter for BA. Now 2 EI, so that we have to consider, which is for your CD member. And knowing these values, we can write as 11, as 13. Now we have 6 EI upon 4 square anticlockwise, so minus. You can see as 31 we have minus because it is towards left. Reaction you can say at B, that is towards left, so as 13 is also minus. Now if you will go to as value at S32, then you have, that is also minus. So you can see here S at 2, 3, this is also minus. So here you have 6 in bracket 2 E upon 2 square. Here also you have same value. So we are being these values, and if you will now see this one. So I have S 2, 3, then I have S 1, 3. You can see over here, we have S 1, 3 over here. We have S 2, 3 over here, and S 3, 3 we have over here. So knowing these stiffnesses and analysis for resistance structures, first is simple one. Second is simple one, already I told you, but for third, we have to go for these reactions. Then we can have, for both, we have to calculate HB for AB, and we have to calculate HD for HC for CD. And then we have to add this. So HB we are going to get as 0.313 kilonewton, and HC we are going to get that as 10 kilonewton because we have fixed symmetrical. So my minus 3.33 plus 3.33 gets cancelled, and reaction at C and D we are going to get same as 10 kilonewton because total load divided by 2. And then knowing FDL3 we can formulate the equation. So we have, this will be 9.687. So now we can have displacement, that is stiffness value. So you just put these values which we have seen over there. So we are going to be with these values. So first we have for unit displacement at 1, second remain next three values we have at unit displacement 2, then we have at unit displacement 3. And likewise, by using this equation, we are in position to formulate the equations. And then formulation of equation, we have to just substitute the values, and by substituting the values in this, we are going to get these three equations. So by solving these three equations for three unknown displacements, we will get values of three displacement, that is EI theta B, EI theta C, and EI delta. So knowing these three values, we can use the slope deflection equation, and by using slope deflection equation, we are in position to calculate the final moments at A, final moment at C, B, C, and D. So now we will go with this solution of the equation. So we have theta b 1.197 upon EI, theta c minus 1.789 upon EI, and delta minus 4.582 upon EI. And then substitute values in this as theta a 0. So your this term becomes your 0 value. So we have this only 2 terms. Now when we will have these values, and then we have 1.19 kilonewton meter. Go for BA. In the same fashion, we have theta A0, and by theta A0, I will get this value as 3.29 kilonewton meter. Now we can go to the BC. So we have in this delta 0, because your sway is not related with beam, so we have theta B and theta C, no delta over there. And then you can substitute the values of this, and then you will get value of MBC minus 3.29 kilonewton meter. Similarly, we can calculate MCB, same way, no delta over there. And in CD, if we will go in CD, we do not have theta D because that is fixed support, so theta D 0, and we will get this value as 3.26 kilonewton meter. And then calculate an MDC, and DC also we do not have theta D, we got this value as 30.50 kilonewton meter. So likewise, we can solve these problems which are related with your stiffness method, and that is for frames. So that we can find, we can do it very easily for beams and frames. So we have these all methods which we are going to use to determine the, or to analyze the indeterminate structures. So today we will stop here only, and thank you.